In this video, we're going to talk about the role of iron in plant culture. Iron is considered a micronutrient, but don't let the name fool you because iron is needed in the highest amount as far as the micronutrients are concerned. And iron is typically one of those elements that most growers have experienced problems with either on deficiencies or toxicities. First, let's talk about iron deficiency. Iron deficiency shows up in the new growth of plants. So as an example, in this calibrachoa, you can actually see a little bit minor iron deficiency where the leaf itself on the new leaves are actually yellow with green veins, which we call interveinal chlorosis. Now, iron deficiency is typically caused by a number of things. First one is pH. As an example, as the pH of the growing media becomes higher, iron deficiency tends to become more of a problem. So as pH goes up, iron becomes less available for plant uptake. So typically you want to try to keep your pH of your growing media between 5.5 and 6.2. You start going above 6.5, it becomes difficult for the plant to obtain the iron. Second thing you want to look at is your application rate. As it is with most complete fertilizers, if our application rate of the fertilizer is low, therefore we're putting on less micronutrients, including iron. So it might be a good idea to look at increasing your fertilizer application rate. Now, in some cases, I find that most fertilizers do not provide enough iron for crops such as an example, the calibrachoa and petunia and a few other crops. In that case, it might be good to supplement with what we call an iron chelate, which will provide additional iron. So iron chelates, the best one is iron EDDHA. There's also an iron DTPA, which is fairly good. And then the standard one that's found in most fertilizers is iron EDTA, which is not widely available over a high pH range. Another thing that can cause an iron deficiency is what we call competition. So as an example, if another micronutrient is high in the growing media, the plant can't tell the difference between, let's say, manganese and iron, so it's going to take up more manganese and create an iron deficiency. One thing that's also curious that could induce an iron deficiency is actually root disease. So as an example, if we take a look at the plant, you want to pull the pot off and examine the root system of the plant. If the roots on the plant are brown, that will indicate that there's a root disease, and that will definitely inhibit the uptake of iron as well as other elements, and iron deficiency will show up quickly. I want to talk about iron toxicity. Iron toxicity can occur mostly based on pH. So if your pH of your growing media drops below 5.5, what happens is iron availability is greatly increased and can show up. The crops that are most susceptible to iron toxicity would be crops such as geraniums, New Guinea impatiens. We also have lisianthus, marigolds, and pentas are also susceptible to iron toxicity. Now, iron toxicity could also show up as a result of too much application. If your fertilizer application rate's real high, it also brings a high level of iron. In a few cases, there might be a lot of iron coming from your water source. We've seen it even with control-release fertilizers, where sometimes they'll dump at a very fast rate and provide too many micronutrients. So I want to thank you for listening.
For more information, visit our website. Follow us on social media.